Red Wings Live is presented by Spartan Stores. For locations, visit turntospartan.com. The Tar loose here to Helm. Right in. Scores! Darren Helm! It's 3-2! Welcome inside the studio following a Saturday night of Original Six hockey down at the Joe. The Wings and Rangers entertaining the masses in this one as the Wings fight back from a 2-0 deficit to win this one 3-2. Darren Elliott and Chris Osgood paying close attention here inside the studio. Darren, what impressed you most about the way the Wings come back and stole 2 points from the Rangers here tonight?
My prediction. I said they would win on the power play. They did. The Rangers' power play. The penalty kill was absolutely phenomenal. They got busy. They got after it. And I really like the fact that they won the battle of the trenches.
Yeah, for me it was 2-0 at the time. The Rangers were physically taken to the Red Wings. Red Wings weren't winning the battles. Then they got a big boy victory. They stood up, they accepted the challenge, got physical, started driving the net. Penalty kill was unbelievable once again tonight, probably one of the reasons why they won. And Jimmy Howard, who was down 2-0, made big save after big save and showed why he was one of the best goalies in the National Hockey League tonight.
And one of the guys who's always instrumental on the power play, Drew Miller, fighting through pain tonight to stay out there and take one for the team in a big win. He stopped by postgame and chatted things up with our John Keating. Guys?
All right, Trev, thanks. A terrific effort, top to bottom, really, from your team. At one point, we were worried about you. Take us through what happened when you had to come off the ice.
Yeah, I thought I was cut there. My knee kind of went numb, and I wasn't sure. Just punctured my kneecap pretty good, and it was pressing against my kneecap, and I couldn't move my knee because of that. So a little scary there, but I was able to come back and be there with the boys at the end.
So shin guard gave its all, I guess, today.
Yeah, I think I'll be getting a new one tomorrow.
All right, so your team faced all kinds of penalty-killing problems, really, at games. And 5 minutes and 24 seconds of power play time they had, and they only had 3 shots. And part of that time, you're without your stick. How much panic can set in those kinds of circumstances?
Yeah, you don't want to break your stick off a block on the first draw there. You just try to stay tight and count on the other guys and to use their sticks and to make the plays, and Howie came up with some big saves there, so that's huge.
Some wins just feel better than others. This has to be one of those.
Yeah, this win's huge. I think we kind of didn't start out the way we wanted to. They got a couple of goals and got ahead of us there, and we fought with it, stayed with it, and came out on top tonight, so it's a big win for us.
Just gave me a smile because you realized it's Mike Babcock's 500th win. That's special for all the guys in the room, isn't it?
Yeah, it's special for everyone, but I was smiling because I get to talk to you, Keats.
Okay. Well, this is officially final. Drew Miller is full of it, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, congratulations on the win. We appreciate your time.
Yeah, thanks, Keats.
Drew Miller and the Wings will celebrate this one as they come from behind and beat the Rangers here tonight, T.
And Keats, they beat them for the first time in 6 meetings. Certainly the penalty kill, a big part of that tonight, Darren. Ozzie.
Yeah, their penalty kill was great tonight once again. It has been all year, but tonight they really rose to the occasion. 2 back-to-back 5-on-3s, ice-picking penalty, and Murray St. Louis that probably maybe shouldn't have been. But you know what? They stayed mentally strong, tough, and they dealt with what came to them. And they did great on the penalty kill, great outs, but really supporting like they have been all year. Right here, Eric's a nice little touch pass, and Helm does a great job of bringing us up the middle and getting this puck out. You can see the confidence of the Red Wings' penalty kill is sky high right now.
What they do so well, Glenn Denning, really trying to draw the call, taking time off the clock, 5-on-3, having the confidence to do so, smart play, gets the change. But I like the way they defend and pressure to the boards. Their support, as you said, Ozzy, been outstanding all season long when down a man. Fantastic job all season long. It's got to put them 7-for-7 in a game like this. They win the game because of it, but it's got to put them right at the top of the league in terms of penalty kill percentage.
For me, this is becoming a weapon of theirs. Obviously, when teams come to play against the Red Wings, they know they have a good penalty kill. And tonight, the Rangers look like they're confused, weren't quite certain of what to do, even on the 5-on-3. Looks like they're confident. And the Red Wings really bottled them up, took it to them. And really, between their penalty kill, Jimmy Howard, Miller, and Helm is the reason why they won this game tonight.
Yeah, he had Dan Boyle back in the lineup, and he looked a little unsure, even though he's a veteran, back on the blue line, on the point. And he had Rick Nash. I didn't like his work down low, but you had to give Danny DeKeyser and those guys credit for boxing out, doing a good job down by the crease.
Guys, we saw on the note there, they killed over 5 minutes of continuous penalty time. What does that do to your lines? I guess some guys have to sit out and they don't get into the rhythm. You can't flow your lines like you want to. How did they adjust to that after that point in the game?
Well, I think if anything have changed this season compared to last is Pavel Datsyuk and Henrik Zetterberg don't kill penalties like they used to. and it makes them that much more potent 5-on-5 and saves energy for the power play, which has been fabulous the last 10 games, even more than that. But the penalty kill guys like Miller, what I was most impressed with Glenn Denny, his clock awareness, 5-on-3, instead of just shooting it down, giving it back to the Rangers, he killed off the rest of that 5-on-3 by taking it into the corner, burying himself in the corner and killing more time off. Just great awareness by a young player.
7:43, almost 8 minutes of PK time for Glenn Denning, almost 6 minutes for Drew Miller. Those guys are the anchors to the penalty killing success the Red Wings have had this season.
And as they always say, you guys being goaltenders would know, your goaltender is usually your best penalty killer. Jimmy Howard had another good night tonight. Your thoughts on his play?
We thought that he might have been one shot away, just not because of his play, of being pulled from this game when it was 2-0 in the first. If the next one goes in, you're Mike Babcock, you go, oh man, maybe I have to give Jimmy a, you know, get him out of there and save him for tomorrow. But instead, Jimmy Howard was phenomenal when it was 2-0 in that first period to keep it right there. And he just got better as the game went along.
Well, people, I wonder about Jimmy Howard's mental toughness. Please don't anymore. It was 2-0, and he's done this all year. He's shut the door when he's had to, and he's made big save after big save when the game is in doubt for his team. And tonight was no different. This was a... He manned up when it was 2-0. He made save after save, big save, and it was like he was telling his teammates, I'm not letting in another goal. You guys go out and get it for me, and that's exactly what happened. And he made probably 10 great saves to keep it at 2-0.
It's interesting because as a goaltender, you can get, oh, you made great saves. But if the team doesn't come back, it's forgotten, and you end up losing whatever the score ends up being. But Jimmy Howard, mentally, he just focused on the task at hand, which is the next shot, the next shot, the next shot. And finally, the guys got going in the middle of this hockey game and took it all the way home.
Now, we can see what the guys did penalty killing. We see what the offense did. We know what Jimmy Howard did tonight. But when you talk about a guy like Drew Miller, what does he bring to the table? Talk about the intangibles that guy brings each
you
and every
You call
night.
Him slippery tonight.
He was slipping and sliding around out there. He was slithering down the boards. He was unhittable. He was going down the boards, getting pucks out. Really, on the second goal, his physical play along the boards, he made a very good player, not only stripping the puck, but now he gets on his horse, starts skating through the neutral zone, attacks the net here. This is a great play by him, taking it to the hole, getting it there, and Glenn Denning following up and banging it. But Drew Miller's a smart player. He doesn't get enough credit for that. He does all the dirty work for the Red Wings. Here he takes a skate to the leg. He's injured. Then he did come back from this, though. But he's one of those guys, that unsung hero for the Red Wings. And tonight, for me, he was the first star. He did every little thing right, and the things that it takes to win a hockey game, he did for the Red Wings.
And think of how important that was, not just for the long term, but in the short term and the outcome of this game, that he wasn't hurt more severely and wasn't cut. He came back and was great on the penalty kill, even without a hockey stick.
But he is a hockey player. He plays hurt. He plays in pain. Drew Miller doing what he can to help the team win here tonight, and a big win it was. We are just getting started with the guys on this one tonight. When we come back, we'll have highlights of tonight's action and post-game comments from Mike Babcock and the players. We'll see if we can get Darren Helm's thoughts on a big night for him as the offense keeps rolling. We're back after you watch this. Highlights are next. Tonight's highlights are brought to you by Xfinity. Cam Talbot in net for the Rangers in place of Henrik Lundqvist. The Wings went with their number one guy, Jimmy Howard. Quite a battle between these two tonight. No score midway through the first. A scramble in front leads to a Chris Klein spinning backhander past Jimmy Howard, and it's 1-0. Blue Shirts, who are wearing white tonight. Later in the period, Wings on the turnover to Rick Nash. He's done that many times against the Red Wings. His 17th of the year gives New York a 2-0 lead. Stayed that way till 5 minutes left in the second. Wings changed that in a hurry. Stephen Weiss to Riley Sheahan, a backhand of his own, beats Cam Talbot. 2-1, Wings trail. Less than 30 seconds later, they get even. Drew Miller streaking up the side. Shifty little move here, gets to the net, puts one on Talbot, makes the first save, but there's Luke Glendening jamming it in on the doorstep. We're tied at 2. To the third we go. Thomas Tatar finds Darren Helm, who finds the back of the net. Quick little wrister beats Talbot. The Wings have their first lead of the game with 11 minutes left. Then the Rangers late in the game go on not one but 2 5-on-3s. The Wings, including Jimmy Howard, stand tall. Guys, what kind of goaltending is this?
Well, it's great goaltending. That is outstanding. Glove save by Jimmy Howard. Right in Murray St. Louis' kitchen. Stones him.
St. Louis scored many times in that position.
Yeah, yes, he has. But that deserved a 3-2 win for the home team tonight. There you see the particulars. Nash is 17th. Klein is 5th. Hagler picks up an assist tonight. Darren Helm gets his 5th of the year. Luke Glendening and Riley Sheahan also getting goals for the Red Wings in a big comeback win for them tonight. That was your Motor City game summary. When we come back, it's Inside the Locker Room. We go for more post-game reaction from the head coach and his players on a really big win. In fact, the 500th of Babcock's career. What do you think about that? Find out next. And that old adage, it's not how you start, it's how you finish, does have some merit in the game of hockey, as in the game of life. But in the game of hockey, Mike Babcock relentlessly pounds home the importance of starting on time. Didn't quite happen for the Wings tonight as they got down 2-0, but that finish, well, that seems to be the Wings' calling card all season long. Here's Mike Babcock's thoughts on tonight's game from start to finish back at the Joe, a win where he collects career victory number 500.
Well, I mean, the 2 points tonight means way more. I thought that was a little gutty win. You know, we got down 2-0 and weren't as competitive as we'd like to be, and that really battled our way back. A lot of gutty efforts. Glennie's line in the penalty kill was outstanding. Homer had as good a game maybe as he's had this year. And, you know, got to give credit to how he is. It doesn't always go the way you want as a goalie, and it hadn't gone the way you wanted in the first, but he just, you know, put up a wall of plywood there. And you know, if they get three, we don't win. And so it was a real good job by Howie here today, I thought, in the final 40 minutes.
You talked the last few games about wanting to get the PK better. It certainly stood on its head tonight.
Well, I thought it was incredible. You know, anytime you put your stick up and they can make calls, it's tough when they're 5-on-3s. It's really tough, but our guys really got it out and dug in. And you know, sometimes those guys don't score as much for us. But when you think the guys today that did some scoring for us, real competitive guys that penalty kill and grind for us, and that's what you need on some nights.
Sheehan goal kind of settled things down for you guys and kind of...
Well, I think it gave us a chance to get going. And, you know, if you look at their second goal, the breakaway goal, I don't really know what we were doing. We had dominated two shifts in a row, and then suddenly we're standing between the hash marks as a D-man, and they're on a breakaway. You know, who knows why those things happen? They do sometimes. But I thought our ability to just kind of stay with it and be patient and battle back and not panic gave us a chance to really battle and compete, and then I thought we were ultra competitive. That's why it's great to see guys like Helmer and Glennie and those guys score in those situations. I mean, a big goal from Sheehan, but those guys, when they compete that hard, it's nice when they're rewarded.
You said this morning, you know, Helm had a great game last game, wanted to see it again. I mean, that's what you saw tonight, isn't it?
Well, for sure, and I mean, you just want to keep them going. We got a lot of players that are getting better. I mean, Weiss is a guy getting better each game, and so when you look through it, for a guy like Helmer, if he can continue to improve and get back to the level he was at, we're a better hockey team.
You'd like to win start to finish, but I would guess your young players are gaining confidence with every one of these games that you sort of squeeze out at game's end.
Sure, I mean, it's going to be tight every night. That's just the way the league is. Now we got to find a way to, you know, get a meal in us and get energy and get ready to play tomorrow. I mean, Carolina doesn't care that it was a tight, hard-fought game today. They're ready to jump on us tomorrow. So we got to get our mind right and get ready to play. And when you got good players and good leadership, you have a chance.
500 won't mean as much to you until you get into retirement, perhaps?
Correct. You know, I mean, don't get me wrong. 500's great. Doing it with so many good players and good teams is really great. You know, when you start in a league, you're hoping to coach 82 games, to be honest with you. You're just hoping to get through and not get fired. And then your second year, you're hoping to get another 82, and then you don't think about it anymore. You kind of have the same mind you had when you coach college hockey. You're just coaching and doing what you love to do. And so to have 500 wins in the National Hockey League means I've coached a lot of good players. But I like the fact that, you know, we've done it fairly quickly too, and that's positive. So it's been enjoyable. I love it as much or maybe more than the day I started. So maybe keep letting me do it.
Coach, when you started, if you saw your name next to Cole Blake and somebody said, you know, you'd have 500, you'd be right there, what would you think?
Well, I mean, the big one for me, obviously, is Scotty Bowman, because he's such a good friend of mine, is that, Scotty Bowman is always going to be the greatest coach in our game, because it's impossible in the era today to do what Scotty did. But when you're a friend of his and it's good. You know, he's the guy who did it quicker than I did, and he should do it quicker. Like, it's just, I feel like that, so it's positive. See you guys.
So big congratulations to Mike Babcock on career win number 500 tonight. Ozzie, you played for the guy. Tell me about the milestone and what do you think it means to him and how he got it done.
Yeah, just his attention to detail constantly, day in and day out, I think rubs off on his players, where guys know what's expected of them. They know they have to be good in their own zone. They know they have to skate. They have to work hard, be accountable each and every game, and they know what's expected. I think that's the key to his coaching. Yeah, he can be tough, but he allows guys for their talent to come out within the system, but they have to play within the system. And once they do that, he'll allow guys a longer leash to do what they want to do. And I see the Red Wings play, which is Mike Babcock's team, compared to a lot of teams I've seen this year, and they play more of a team game. They play together more, and they do it longer and better than any other team I've seen this season.
Yeah, and I've always enjoyed Mike Babcock, first covering him from an outside perspective, not part of the team. And I always learn from the thing I've watched over his career. He's adapted. He hasn't adapted to his philosophy in terms of hard work and what Ozzie's talking about. What he's adapted to is the style of play, defensive zone coverages, what you do, what the buzzwords are. He has adapted. He's changed, not so much based on his personnel, but based on what works best. So you have to be open-minded to a certain degree, but closed-minded as well to make sure you make everybody accountable.
Yeah, for sure. And like I said before, I think after watching a lot of teams play around the league this year, the Red Wings play a lot better. Yeah. They do the little things better than any other team, and that starts in practice, that starts in preparation. It starts when they're watching video. Mike Babcock expects these guys, from the guy that sits out and doesn't play to the best player, to all do the same things, and they all do. And when you watch the Red Wings play, they do it better, longer, and their attention to detail is much better than most teams in the National Hockey League.
In his post-game comments, he gave a lot of the credit to some of the great players he's coached along the way. Let's talk about the players that he's coaching on this team specifically this year. What is he doing that's making this team so effective this year with the personnel he's got, Chris?
Well, I think he's giving them the opportunity to go out and perform, and these guys are good players. But if anything, I think for the first time in two or three years, these guys know what their roles are. They have four good lines. Each one of these lines know what their roles are. These guys aren't going anywhere. We were talking earlier before he came on the air. Darren will speak of it in a couple of minutes from now if I keep flapping here. But they're just, they got six defensemen. They all know what their roles are, including Lashoff, who's in and out of the lineup, who's, to me, one of the better sevens in the National Hockey League. The goalies know what their roles are. Each and every forward, the four lines, they have specific roles. They're all not the same. To me, this team is more of a team than it has been in 2 years.
Well, the young guys feel they belong. Right now, it's their team. They're part of it. So if you take a look at it from that standpoint, that's one of the reasons. The other thing is, I think, is organizational. As Ozzie was talking about, they know what their roles are. They know they're going to be here. And they made that decision. Thomas Yurko, they had the option. He wasn't playing very well, got off to a slow start, didn't send him to Grand Rapids. They thought it'd be better keep him here, sit him out, see how he responds. That message permeated the locker room, the lineup, and you see the results ever since.
The results have been fantastic so far. I know a lot of people are surprised, but I don't think Mike Babcock will be counted among them. He's got a good thing going here, that's for sure. When we come back, we'll go back inside that Red Wing locker room. We'll hear from Babcock's players and get their thoughts on tonight's big win, including that guy right there, Jimmy Howard. Hear what he has to say about a win and the way he performed this evening against the Rangers. When we come back to Red Wings Live after you watch this. Tonight's Total Impact is brought to you by Total Hockey. Missed the Wings 2 goals in the second period in less than 30 seconds. It erased a 2-goal deficit. They eventually scored the game winner in the third and took a victory over the original six rivals from New York tonight. Your final score, 3-2 at the Joe. And in that game, Jimmy Howard made 27 saves for the win, and he is talking up things inside the Red Wings locker room right now. Let's take you there, and it's an interview brought to you by Menards. Save big money on all your home improvement needs at Menards.
Yeah, that was huge. It was showed a lot of character by our guys and a lot of heart. Probably not the best recipe there to, you know, close out a game, but we found a way, and that's all that matters.
This seems to be the consensus after a lot of games lately, finding a way, and a lot of scoring lately, too.
It's just no quit, you know, in our team. It doesn't matter. We just keep fighting. You know, obviously that wasn't the start we wanted. The first period giving up two, you know, especially to a good team like that, that can haunt you. But we did a great job of battling back, and she got us going in there in the second. Then, you know, Glennie going hard, and Helmer getting the game winner for us.
I guess the good news is that you came back again. The bad news is that you had to come back again, and that's got to be a bit of a concern going forward.
Yeah, it'd be nice for, you know, to get started on time here one of these games. So, you know, we're going to keep working at it. Don't really know, have the answer to why it's happening, but it is. But at the same time, we're doing a lot of great things out there, and, you know, we're winning games. So
you kept your team in the game early. How much were you feeding on the defensive effort down the stretch?
We did a great job. You know, even in the first period, that you know, Nash, he's, you know, pretty good there, and he, you know, he buried it. But you know, we kept fighting the whole night, and you know, the guys really bared down there late in the third, and it was great to see.
And tonight's Fox Sports Detroit Red Wing Player of the Game is presented by McDonald's new Fresh Baked McCafe Blueberry Muffin is Jimmy Howard. 27 saves, 2 goals against, 7 saves on the power play tonight, definitely contributing to an effective power penalty kill for the Red Wings. His first win over the Rangers in quite some time. Jimmy Howard, your McDonald's Player of the Game. And Jimmy was the first up inside the Red Wings locker room. Next up, Riley Sheahan, who scored tonight as well. More post-game chatter coming your way from inside the Red Wings locker room after we return here on Red Wings Live. Red Wings Live is brought to you by Spartan Stores. For locations, visit turntospartan.com. And by Menards. Save big money on all your home improvement needs at Menards. Well, the Rangers jumped out to a 2-0 lead tonight, but the Red Wings came back with 3 unanswered goals. Riley Sheahan got the offense started tonight, and he's talking things up with our John Keating back inside the Red Wings locker room.
All right, Trev, thanks. One of the goals, that from Riley Sheahan. Congratulations on the win. How good did this one feel when you look back at it? From start to finish, because it wasn't the start that your team wanted.
Yeah, for sure. I think just showed a lot of character, and especially with the kills there we had at the end, and a lot of guys going down and blocking shots. Howie doing a great job for us, and I think we started off slow, but we came back and we finished strong, so it was good.
Knowing this team, it's the kills really that you'll remember more so than the goals that brought you back into the game.
Yeah, for sure. That last 12-10 minutes was pretty crucial for us, and we had a lot of control out there on our penalty kill, and I think when you do that, it just builds confidence, and I think that's one of the big things that's been good for us is our penalty kill, so it's been good.
This place was rocking at game's end. It felt special out there, didn't it?
Yeah, for sure. It definitely helps when you have fans helping you out like that, and being loud and cheering, so it definitely helps a lot, and we love playing here in our own arena.
It's tough, 5-on-3s back-to-back in the third period. That's a big hole to dig, especially against a Rangers team that has got some potency to it.
Yeah, we did an amazing job, and I think in particular Glennie and Millsy and Andy Helmer, even with the broken stick there too, showed a lot of character and blocking shots and playing a little extra hard.
All right, the players got the head coach his 500th win. That's kind of special, isn't it?
Yeah, it's special. To be honest, I didn't even know that going in, but yeah, it's awesome, and just got to keep the streak going.
Riley, thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
When we come back, it's time to reset the show with our analysts. Darren and Chris will chime in from the studio. Ken and Mick are down to the Joe. It's all coming your way next as Red Wings Live continues here on Fox Sports Detroit. Wings found themselves in a 2-0 hold of the Rangers tonight. Still, Stephen Weiss found Riley Sheahan for a backhand goal, and then 30 seconds later, Drew Miller threw one in front of the net that Luke Glendening jammed home. Game was tied going to the third, and the Wings would get the game winner in that period. Tomas Tatar finds Darren Helm, who snipes one past Cam Talbot. 3-2, another come-from-behind victory for the Wings at the Joe this evening. And what you did not see in those highlights were some hits, and Aussie hits really turned this thing around and got the Wings going tonight.
Merrily, with the score 2-0, Luke Glendening got drilled along the boards, and the answer, well, Brendan Smith with a beautiful hit in the neutral zone really put the Rangers on notice, and here's the hit to Glendening on the sideboards. Now it's 2-0 at this time, and here, Brendan Smith, not long after, stands up with a beautiful hitter on Brassard. And this kind of put the Rangers on notice, but more so, let the Red Wings know, hey, it's time to get physical, boys. We've got to step this game up. And each and every one of those players on that bench saw that, and they stepped up after that and really took the play of the Rangers after that particular hit.
I think a very astute observation, because there wasn't much going on. All the trench warfare, all the battles all along the boards in front of the nets were being won by the Rangers. Smith steps up, makes that big open ice hit on the PK, and after that, They got busy, they got after it, and they got a couple goals in the second period.
They got a couple of goals in the second period, and that was really the turning point. Three unanswered goals, both of them, two of them rather, came in the second, Darren.
Yeah, and what we're going to show you is an example of what we're talking about. Just a simple board battle. One, you have Bronson in the open ice, a willingness to take the puck and not give it up, wait for help, and they get on the board.
That was a sneaky assist by Bronson here, just to hold off, just a little tap of the puck here, just to let it sit somewhere where a nice pass can be by Weiss, and a beautiful old school backhander by Shane, who continues to stay hot.
And this is your favorite one. Miller wins a board battle, gets going in the open ice, and this was the slippery move. Whoops! Slithering. Gets it to the net. Glendening with the shovel, puts it in the snowbank, back of the net, and we're tied at two.
And the Red Wings have really shown a lot of resiliency this year. Coming back when they're down, third periods have been huge for this team. As we have a look at the updated standings with another 2 points for the Wings here tonight. Really, right there near the top of the Atlantic Division. I know, Darren, you're not surprised by this, but a lot of people looking at the standings may be just 2 points behind Tampa Bay. How are they getting it done?
Well, we've seen it. When we talked about it at the beginning of the season, it had to be great goaltending, check. You had to have the young players continue to get better, check. And you had to have relative good health of your two star players up front in terms of the captain, Henrik Zetterberg, check. And Pavel Datsyuk, not so much, but when he's been in the lineup, he's been a factor. So I saw it coming.
Yeah, too. And you predicted it too early on. But to me, this is an exciting time to be a Red Wings fan. This is great stuff. This team is not only played well, but their mental toughness now, they've shown to come back in games, to get in the trenches and win these playoff type atmosphere games like they won tonight. But now the young players are coming along, they've taken that next step, and they have Datsyuk and Zetterberg, Cronwall and Howard are the core guys. And when you have those guys going into the playoffs, you have a chance against anybody, and these young guys continue to get better. It's an exciting time to be a Red Wings fan, and lots to look forward to moving forward.
Yeah, you're right. It's not like they're waiting for the veterans to be to show them the way and what to do. They're doing it.
They certainly are, and it's just showing in the standings, just 2 points out of first in their division. Well, it's that time of the show where we take you back to the rink and get the thoughts of the guys that called all the action tonight. Ken Daniels and Mickey Redmond, they're back with us now to give us their thoughts. Let's join them back of the Joe. Guys, take it away.
Well, down at ice level tonight, Mick, you talked about how the Red Wings have that well-rounded offense, and it came to play tonight, and including Luke Glendening.
Well, it really did. Started by Shan. And this line, the fourth line, I mean, we didn't talk about a lot the fourth line, because they don't score that often. But, boy, did they get a big one tonight. And they were on the ice on the follow-up shift after the Riley Sheahan goal for a complete 1 minute and 1 second. And this was in behind the net. There's 41 Glendening. Watch what Miller does here to Hunwick down the far boards. He makes a stutter step right there. Boom. He's around him. And look at 41 coming down the slot. Anderson's going, driving the net. Looks like an innocent enough play, but one-handed, Miller goes to the net. They get a lucky bounce, yes, off a stick and off a skate. And Glendening finishes it off to score his first goal on a forehand, not the backhand. Good job by Anderson to occupy everybody in front. And watch this. Off the stick, off the toe of the skate, and Glendening. And like that, all of a sudden, this game was all Rangers until the Sheahan goal. A minute one later, that's a long shift for anybody to be on the ice. And these guys tie the game, and it allows the Helm to get the winner. But you talk about the Sheahan line. The Datsyuk line was strong again, lots of chances. Goals coming from number five for Helm, number five for Sheahan. But your fourth line gets you the big goal to set it all up. And boy, the penalty kill, 7 minutes and 43 seconds. Mr. Glendening spent a lot of that 5-on-3.
And you think about it, for the first time in seven games, the Red Wings don't get a power play goal. Their penalty killing for just the second time in seven games is perfect, and they killed off seven, the most they've had to kill off all season in a game.
Not often do you see 5-on-3s, let alone back-to-back 5-on-3s, and involved a 4-minuter, and in one of them you got Quincy off. You had Miller hurt for the first one. We thought he had a cut leg. He was gone. You had Quincy, who was off, who's a penalty killer. Then B-52, Erickson's off on the second one. They did an unbelievable job, and through all of that, the leader of that pack was Jimmy Howard. I don't know how he was in first star of the game.
Yeah, probably should have been.
Late in the first period, I said to our guys downstairs, keep a couple of those saves by Jimmy Howard. This game goes 3-0. I'm afraid it's all over. It's a long night for Detroit. He was really, really good. Through about 4 or 5 minutes, it was all Rangers the last 10 minutes of the period, and that allowed his team to stay in. He gave you the goaltending that allows your team a chance to come back and win. They found another way to do it tonight, and it's all going all around with everybody on deck. And wouldn't surprise me if Jimmy gets a rest tomorrow.
Right.
And we see Mrazek in Carolina.
Yep, we'll have that for you 4:30 with Red Wings Live.
All right, guys, thank you very much. And here's a look at the upcoming schedule that they just spoke about. Back at it tomorrow night at 5 p.m. start against the Hurricanes in Carolina. And a couple of days off before the Wings finish off their season series against the Maple Leafs with a home-and-home beginning Wednesday. And then Saturday, the Panthers are squeezed in between there on a Friday night at the Joe. Time for another timeout on this edition of Red Wings Live. When we come back, take you to the Palace. Show you how the Pistons and Sixers fared. Went to overtime. Who won? I'm going to tell you. You stick around. Back to the matter at hand at the Joe tonight. Stephen Weiss back at it offensively. He picked up another assist and now has points in six of the seven games he's played in since his return. Let's take you inside the Red Wings locker room now for his post-game comments.
Trev, thanks. Points in six of seven games for you since you've come back. How much are you now just playing and not thinking about playing?
Yeah, that's the fun part about it. Don't have to worry about anything other than just playing. When things are going well for you offensively, it's fun to play and just trying to keep it going.
You know how tough this Rangers team can be. When it's 2-0 in the first period, that's a pretty big hole that your team dug for itself. What's said in the first intermission?
Well, just stick with it. Obviously we knew it wasn't the start we wanted, so we had to get better from top to bottom, and we did that. We just chipped away in the second and third period. Obviously, our penalty killing and how we was a difference in the hockey game. Anytime you can kill off 2 5-on-3s for that amount of time, it's huge, and we'll take the 2 points.
You've played enough here now that you have a sense as to what Joe Louis Arena is like. It seemed to have a particular buzz tonight that perhaps you haven't seen yet.
No, it was one of the better ones, no doubt about it. The third period was fun to play in, those are fun hockey games. That's why I wanted to come here, to play in front of fans like these, it's been a blast.
Is it building for your team right now?
Yeah, I think so. Anytime you're winning, you gain confidence, especially when you win games like that where we didn't have our A game early on, but we stuck with it and just found a way to win. It wasn't pretty. It's not something we'll look at video and want to emulate that game by any means, but we got the win.
I got to believe your confidence is building as well.
It's getting there. Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, anytime you can contribute offensively, it takes some weight off your shoulders, and just trying to ride the wave as long as it can.
Steven, thanks.
Thank you.
In a comeback win like this, you know you want to relive the highlights. We've got you covered. Our instant replay is coming your way next as Red Wings Live rolls on here on Fox Sports Detroit. Red Wings Live is brought to you by MIHealthCoverage.com. Visit MIHealthCoverage.com, your source for individual health insurance. An original six matchup is something you just can't get enough of. It's great to see the Rangers and the Wings tangle anytime, anywhere. And in case you missed some of tonight's action or you want to relive it all over again, we've got you covered in tonight's instant replay.
It's the 580th meeting with the New York Rangers and the second of three this season and first of two here as the Wings look for their first win in six tries over New York. Kindle couldn't corral it back to the net. A chance here for the Rangers in front. Heinen down low. Backhand shot, another one, they score! Klein, a couple of whacks at that puck. He's got a career-high 5 goals on the season. And the Rangers lead 1-0.
Let's go here.
And a break as Nash is in from the blue line, in all alone, he scores! Boy, Rick Nash continues to put up the points against the Red Wings. Sitting, tied up by Hunwick. Left it by Shane, back in, scores! Riley Shane, it's 2-1! Stepniak tried to come up front with it, couldn't, and Miller's away. Quincy joining. Miller makes the move, shoveled one to the goal. Anderson looked for, they score! Glendening! 2-2 tie! Loose, here Cahill, right in, scores! There
Look at this.
So it's another 5-on-3, and Miller without his stick as the Rangers control. The St. Louis only at the bar, or Howard maybe got a piece on the way through.
See, Miller's got to cover him. He's got no stick.
The Detroit Red Wings, for the first time in 6 meetings with the New York Rangers, are going to win a hockey game. Rangers have won the last 5 as the Red Wings come back from 2 goals down. Not unusual for them this season.
Found another way to win a game.
And they come back on the strength of their penalty kill here tonight. That is for sure. Rick Nash got on the score sheet with the 17th. Chris Klein got his 5th. Carl Hagman picks up an assist for the former Wolverine. Darren Helm, his 5th of the year. Luke Glendening chips in with his 3rd. And Riley Sheahan collects his 6th of the year. 3 unanswered goals for the Wings. It all adds up to a comeback win over the Rangers tonight. 3-2 your final at Joe Louis Arena. And guys, for the 7th time this year, the Wings have come back in the 3rd period to snatch victory from the jaws of defeat.
Yeah, and it's one of the things, too. You heard Mick say they have found ways, and they keep finding different ways. When they have trailed after the first period, they're 4-1-1. That's uncommon in this league, the front-running league. You know, Mike Babcock always talks about it being losing hockey, trailing hockey is losing hockey. Not the way you prefer to play, but the resilient nature of this team is really coming to the forefront with them finding ways to win.
Man, I think it's different individuals stepping on each and every night, and I'm most impressed with that stat sheet is I don't see Zetterberg and Datsyuk on there. Many nights we've seen them, and for success, it's had to be those two guys. Now they can win without those two having to score. Yes, they're still great players, even when they don't get any points. They contribute in other ways that a lot of players in the world can't. But when those guys don't score and the Red Wings are still successful, you know they're trending in the right direction.
Maybe those guys will carry the Red Wings to victory tomorrow, because that'll be the 2nd out of the back-to-back. They're off to Carolina to face the Hurricanes. We'll have a preview with the guys to my left when we come back on this edition of Red Wings Live here on Fox Sports Detroit. Stick around, everybody. To work for the Red Wings as they take a quick flight to Carolina to get back at it tomorrow night. We get things started with Red Wings Live pregame at 4:30. Puck drops between the Wings and the Hurricanes at 5 p.m. on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. And it'll be an opportunity for everybody to get another look at Andre Nesterseau, who left here via waivers and was picked up by the Carolina Hurricanes. What else can you tell us about the Canes, Oz?
I'm going to talk about their goalie, because it ends and starts with him. He's probably the reason why they will have a chance to win this game tomorrow. Their team has been struggling all year. Bill Peters, who was assistant with Mike Babcock, is now the head coach there. But my focus is on the Red Wings after an emotional game tonight against the Rangers, trailing 2-0, coming back and winning 3-2. How are you going to go to Carolina, which is going to be a completely different atmosphere than the Joe? Not nearly as loud. I don't know how many people are going to be there, but it's going to be tough. They got to create their own energy and figure out a way to bring their level back up in order to win that hockey game.
Yeah, and this is a situation where your backup goalie, Peter Mraz, gets a start. You hope to get some energy from him. He's 2-0. That's what you want for your backup.
Looking for him to roll to win number 3 tomorrow. Thanks for watching tonight, guys. We will check it out tomorrow. We'll see you then. Meanwhile, the final score tonight, the Wings come back 3-2 winners over the Rangers at the Joe. For Darren, Chris, and everybody here inside the studio, I'm Trevor Thompson. Thanks for watching. Here's a look at the final take. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.